Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is a continuation of Christianity, and Christianity became corrupt, and that's why the second coming of Jesus took place in India in the name of Nanak in 1469. And he preached gospel through six lives for 150 years, and still darkness could not be comprehended, because the Satan in the East is much stronger than in the Middle East. Judas Iscariot was just rebuked and he killed himself when they killed Jesus. But in India they were terrible, you know, no conscience at all. So here I'm giving a today I went to Oxford, Wycliffe Hall. Over there they have a discussion, you know, quite interesting. Yesterday the retired bishop, Archbishop Rowan William was there. And today we have Nazir Ali, Bishop one of these, and the other, you know, launch of a book by a English lady on Islam, or say biblical, you know. But most of the people, they don't go by the definition. They go by what the people say. And the result is they beat around the bush without understanding. And here is something I've written, that these priests, you know, in these churches, they are anti-Christ. They are worse than those rabbis from the yoke of which Jesus set us free by giving his own sacrifice. And Luke 16, verse 16, clearly states, you know, law and prophets were till John the Baptist. And angel of Israel, prophet Elijah. My God is a Yahweh, that's Elijah stands for. And there is no prophets after him, but the sons of Most High saints. Sons of the Most High God, they are called saints, you know. Prophets are whips for the rabbis, but some prophets were beaten and others maltreated, as the last prophet John the Baptist was. So, you know, they did not treat them well. John the Baptist, he was thrown out of the temple and he was in the wilderness preaching gospel. This Jesus confirmed, you know, that when he went to the temple and gave the last sermon, including the wine press, which was in Jerusalem temple, then he told them, the Father sent his own son, go, and they may recognize him, and they treat you with honor, and they killed him too, you know. So, in the last one, Jesus went to the temple to get the fruit to be presented to our Father, and through fig tree, he told them, you know, that they were beautiful leaves, very refreshing, but no fruit. Same, the temple was highly decorated with gold and other precious metals and other things, but there was no fruit, all show to lure the people. Trap is a trap. So our Father sends his own son to preach gospel to public at large, so that those hungry of his word, oral Torah, can enjoy the feast to their heart's content. Jesus got rid of those crook rabbis by giving his own sacrifice as the Lamb of God, and urged the general public to seek God through his word called Logos, because this new wine is brewed through logical reasoning. only this living in Holy Spirit, common sense. Holy Spirit is nothing else but common sense. We call it Surti in Punjabi. Can brew this new wine. And that is why gospel is hidden under the parables. That only the twice born people of Holy Spirit can dig them out. And it is not on the surface as the letters. On the surface as the letters of the laws are. For the natural once born disciples of the rabbis. So, gospel is hidden from the prudent men of letters, like the university professor you have today. They have no knowledge of gospel. That you find in the universities who are producing hireling, dog-collared priests for the churches of Mammon, such as the dominating church of England. Dominating is very dominating, headed by Queen. Queen is the head of Mammon in Great Britain. That is why her soldiers glorify God by killing and looting third world countries, people. Ideal church is Mammon free. That's why, you know, when they joined the first community, they sold their worldly possession. They were communal. So communists are the nearest to the God. So they were having communal everything. And no Mammon mentioned. Nobody's owned anything. They used to go to the Jerusalem and work for people free. No charge. If somebody gives, good and enough. No asking. And they used to give money to the poor, you know, while, and help them, you know. Church is Mammon free, Church of God, one fold, headed by one Mammon free, philanthropic shepherd, Christ Jesus. Christ Jesus was not a hireling. For philanthropy, Christ Jesus is our chief royal priest. And we are his laborers, the royal priest, who enjoy the fellowship to fish spiritual, solitary, twice-born people called men. For they are masters of their own destiny. As the born blind young man was, answering to the rabbis, not from any book or parents, but from his own heart. Today, the nearest to the Church of God people are Salvation Army people who enjoy fellowship but get paid for their work. Remember, when you do work for God, you don't get paid. If you get paid, then you become Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing, like these hireling dog-collared priests are. Remember Saint Paul, he gave to the church. He did not take anything out of the church. So he used to work as a tent maker to earn his own living. Not dependent upon the church at all. We donate. And we don't, when we donate donation, people donate, you know, a man of no conscience, no salt. At the end of the month, he puts a hand into the donation bag and steals money as his salary, monthly salary. He is not working for God, he is working for Mammon. You have to be careful, you have to be sensible. Enjoys fellowship, but gets paid for their work. In Salvation Army, I think they do pay their people, but some are free, voluntary. They are serving soldiers. Salvation Army serving soldiers. When died, they died for king and country, which is right. And the Mammon's church, they died for God. You know, St. Paul's Cathedral, over there they have these statues of Viceroy of India, Viceroy of South Africa, soldiers and all that. They said they glorified God. And William Booth's nowhere to be found in St. Paul's Cathedral because they were not compatible. So, you have to be careful to worship God in spirit and in truth. So there was no prophet after John the Baptist, and no more rabbis are these hireling dog-collared priests to fulfill Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. Remember, Jesus predicted, you know, that church will be overtaken by these crook messianic Jews who will make the situation worse than before, and that is what happened. First 200-300 years, only the Jewish people were dominating, and they won't let up the outspoken apostle to visit them. They formed presbyters and all that nonsense. So today we have these dog-collared priests, which are worse than anyone you can find. No wonder the chief temple priest, Pope, and his stooges were brutally killing our brethren apostles by throwing them before the lions. They used to throw them before lions too, so that no more light. They love darkness. Today, these messianic Jews are getting bundled up in Israel for the final burning, expected on 14 May 2023, when Israel shall be 75 years old. Our Father Allah knows better, or knows best. So this is something I have written today, and the gospel is not for everyone. It's only for those, you know, who are predestined. And so you should not be frightened. You should preach gospel, and God, our Father, will give you more. But if you keep your mouth shut, you know, you listen and you don't preach, then you will get next to nothing. Our Father God, bless you.